number one. I eased up just to get through the race event, of course. But now we're back to number one. We're on Yas Marina. In our Toyota again, even though I think the Toyota is one of the weaker NASCARs, demonstrated by yesterday's episode. Anyway. Just let's play, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Okay. In the dark though as well as it's meant to be raining. Gas cars all over the place. Ooh. That crash. The pits. Now we're down on a long straight. So well, the last time we were long straight on the children. Push it in. Not happy about that, are they? That me blocking them off. I'm trying to be four. When that's back. Just coming through. Push! Push, now, oh, yeah, I'm trying to get it. Let's go. Flat out. The 17th is pitting in as well as 8th pitting on out. There's a lot of people pitting in early. I think that's probably because of the crash that we had earlier though. Not crash, but collision with one of the cars, I know that for sure. Probably damaged the cars a bit. The way out of Nick is also pitting in. The return back is pitting in. The third is pitting in. Wolf is pitting in. And we're back on the straight. RPMs are increasing. Back on the straight again. And on to the third lap. Just going to fur. Fuel. Christian's got the fuel already. On to the last lap now. Straight. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Race. Push. Conquer. Thank you. top. We've got another 5 races to do.
Exotic locations and world class. Your next race will be at Le Mans, famous for the high-speed Mulsanne Straight.
The hard thing about a cup car in the wet is we just have so much vehicle mass, such a small tire, and then so much horsepower. So you just have to keep those things in mind as you're tiptoeing your way around a racetrack. You just flat out have to be careful.
There's like loads of cool things actually. So you know, there's going to be a time when, well, you know, most of the tracks we are doing at the moment are actually benefiting from different crew. Nationwide on that side. In the rain this time. I can't do that. I thing. Love it. Love it. Come on, you can do this car. Push. Oh, that's a wrench is doing okay-ish. Man, this left track. Oh, I need to get to that again. No, though, it's so hard, you know, to see exactly where the road markings are on the map. It's just so wet out there. Literally. I'm just having to, like, you know, focus. You can almost see beyond what I can see. Because it's just so wet. Look into the future as we launch the fourth lap. It's so wet, you've got the lights on at least, so you can lift back, but still, it's hard to see where the corners actually are. Ooh, NASCAR driver platinum. At least our wings can get a little bit of a wash. Mm. So raining dogs out there. You know what I mean? Like it's not light rain, it's heavy rain. But we are about to just go across the finish line. Come on, car. Victory lane.
Next race will be at Rio de Janeiro, featuring a high-speed straight by the waterfront. Is one of the largest spectator sports in the world, with an estimated 75 million fans.
I didn't put that on. Too busy, I was too quick without race back and think because of our mods and also chat. As I said, you know, you get some really good ones, but it's just, you know, it's just not this track. Come on, We've got some good passes. That last car, definitely. That was an out towards us, so we couldn't go a series without. Series and episode without. These questions don't come about, but actually not too bad. Right, don't break anything else here. Really? You're getting very good sort of simulation though, you know what I mean? You've got simulation damage, no rewind. It's just, you know. This car definitely got the sense. There's also no driving line either. Yeah, this car definitely gets the sense. That's what it's like. Yeah, damage is 100%, but not really like average. You know what I mean? Like, you know, it's not affecting us majorly. We're not steering still fine. Just that we're not getting as much power because one of the brakes is stuck constantly. Got suspension, but still. All 13s is pitting in, 14s is pitting in. Looks that. What's probably happened to them, if these AI are listening to these pitches, you know, when they've just hit something, it's not really affecting much, but yet 23, 24, pitching, you know, it's not really affecting them because there's damage on their, I mean, somewhere, it's just hit. But hey, I suppose it, hey, you know, they have actually hit something too hard. The pitting, I think, you know, gives you that kind of sense. That kind of sense. Well, you know, the pack moving, the pack changing, as people go in and out of the pit. Well, I'm not doing the damage. Two laps though. Working out, we are perfect, we don't have any other cars. But you know, we're only on our second lap. We've got another two more to do. You know, this car is now already a lot weaker. Really extension between 0 and 100, it's always either 0 or 100 in this game. And for the most part, I've never seen, you know, where it's sometimes said 70% or 80%. We're here, like, no, this is completely broken. You need to go in. Sorry, I tried to go into the pit, you know, my wheel was on a hard. Right, he just didn't let me go in. He's so damaged. Of course. I could go in, I just chose not to. And oh, there's our boot. Oh, car is still very much turned to the left. It's weird though, isn't it? Because even though it turns to the left, you turn left, it's about as if it's getting harder to turn left. But also, your car does get dragged more into the left and going on the right hand corner. But, for the moment at least, we have no damage. This is the place we've got damage before. I think this is the hardest part of the track. It's very narrow and you've got, on both ends, you've got some really hard hitting things. Oh, we have got a helicopter flying over, probably recording us. No, too much damage. You know what I mean? It's just too much damage. Come on. A lap time. 10 seconds. Gear 3. Man, we just, okay, our car is jumping, it's literally jumping, it's literally jumping. We've got a kangaroo, not a car. This thing is just... Hey, it's just getting slow, isn't it? It's dropping down. Look, it's just a jumping car. But hey, we didn't damage too much stuff, actually. Our jumping NASCAR. Come on, you can do this car. No! Yeah. Damn it. You know? Too much wreckage. Even though I got to this game, it doesn't matter. I know, that seems, our car was just in such a bad way, it just wasn't even fine. Just spun a car out. No! Stop it, NASCAR! Bad car! And some of the things, NASCAR's not taking too well. Ooh, got a red tire on the road. Car contact. No way. That's first position. Doing much better now. Yes! Come on, push it in! Oh, luckily, our car didn't break. I'm trying to get close to it, but not hit it. Push hard. Good turn, I see. 11 returns. Thank you. four. Last lap. Engine definitely screaming at us a bit more. Actually, we have broken it. Yes. You know, Mr. Clumsy here, yes. You know, everything, you know, we've been perfectly well. For the last lap, and everything gets absolutely be screwed, doesn't it? It gets absolutely screwed. Come on, car, we can do this. We can do this. Badge unlocked, seasonal driver, silver. Just by saying, just hope Lambo or something. 458, Ferrari 458, I am not disappointed
with
that.
In this race, you'll share the track with the best in global touring cars, the premier specification for production-based auto racing. In this race, you can stay in your current car, or you're invited to drive Kevin Harvick's number 4 Stewart Haas Racing Chevrolet, winner of the 2014 Sprint Cup Championships. Your next race
the same
will be
car
at Brands
this
Hatch, originally established
Ooh,
in 1926
the UK,
as a dirt
yeah,
track.
My country. It's what we like, don't we? The UK. Yay. Brands Hatch, though. My man.